So after two full starts, it's Charlene Guinart and Marco Fabbri. Let's hope that the two full starts haven't taken them out of their rhythm. Really great twizzles. Handsomely received. These scores are exceptional. Love that. Wow. Well, I have to say, after Stepana Bambukin, I didn't think that we'd see anything better, but we just might have. And didn't they react well to the frustration of having the wrong music queued up, the long wait. They straight into those very difficult twizzles, and they took it from there, and the judges, you can see, they can hardly separate them. It's going to be nip and tuck.
Yeah, regardless of who finishes top today on the rhythm dance, it's going to be all about the free dance tomorrow. I can't wait. That will be what will tell these two pairs apart. The judges went with that on the technical so much. You can see there the 2.9 grade of execution for the final element, the diagonal step sequence, level 3. That's the highest grade of execution for anything today. And they gave a higher GOE for the Italians' twizzles than they did for the Russians, which is interesting because the difficulty on the Russians for me was the highest we've seen today. But these two just executed everything with the utmost precision. They remind you why experience and maturity is such a factor in ice dancing, don't they?
They sure do.
With it comes a quality that you just can't shortcut.
Yeah, she's 29, he's 30, and they have... Well, it's amazing because this is their ninth season together. And it still looks as fresh as new. In fact, fresher than I can remember it.
They've had such a breakthrough in the last couple of seasons, haven't they? They've really stuck with it and believed in themselves. I'm sure they've had people around them that have really believed it as well, not least Barbara Fusopoli. These are the Twizzles. Wow. Boy, do these stand up to scrutiny.
And it really helps. I mean, they must have been hoping, I guess, hope that Catalini and Lanotti retired. Because, it, you know, to come in as the Italian number ones, that makes a hell of a difference.
Of course. Absolutely. They don't have to be in anyone's shadow anymore. They can shine. And there was such conviction to everything they did today. This was beautiful. Really nice lines. Beautifully executed. Nice bit of creativity and innovation. She loved it. That's great to see. Well, what are the judges going to do with this? All coming down to the components, I think.
And it means the Italian Federation can push them as the number ones.
Well, for me, the program I'll remember is the Russians. But there was a quality about this that will stand the test of time.
78-18, they need it. It's close. Second, but a very high score. A deduction there. I'm not quite sure what that was for. Maybe a length and a length. But 77-36. It will, as Catherine said, be decided tomorrow. The gold medal between the Russians and the Italians. So that's where we are. Stepanova and Bukin, the leaders. Gina and Fabry in second place. Lorraine and Quinn in third. And then lower down. They led for a while, the Finns. Turkila and Veslius. But it is going to be a shootout for the gold medal between Stepanova and Bukin and Gina and Fabry.